come in and give a lecture. Yeah. Okay.
So we've been developing some formal ideas, and I think today what we want to do is we just want to put some of them into practice. And so this lecture is going to be a lot of demonstration, no proof, not much proof. So let's start with the end of last spat of material, which is what we're going to start out with now. And so I'll remind you, any real symmetric matrix. Just say that otherwise, I won't really put it in the theorem, but otherwise, for anti-symmetric and orthogonal, diagonalization may only be unitary. Okay. So we're going to start by looking at some examples of this. So some examples of this. So let's look at a symmetric matrix that's real. So we have A is equal to A transpose. Okay. A is equal to, and I'll just pick a really simple one, 2, 2, 1. And then we can go ahead and find its eigenvalues. Lambda 1 is equal to minus 1. Lambda 2 is equal to 3. And finally, normalized eigenvectors associated with them. And this will be 1 over root 2 minus 1 over root 2. Diagonal. So if we were to diagonalize this, we're going to basically use P inverse AP, with P equal to, and all we do is we take these two eigenvectors and we make a matrix out of them, and that's going to be the matrix P. And we can do this in one of two ways. We can do x1, x2, or we can do x2, x1. It doesn't matter the order. Okay, so we'll just do x1, x2. We'll say 1 over root 2 minus 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2. Okay. I do the example with the other P in the notes, but I'm going to do it now. Notice P transpose P is equal to I. And then let's just find out. A diagonal exposing. Okay. And then we're going to have A, 1, 2, 2, 1, and then P regular, so it's going to be 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2, minus 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2. I need a symbol for 1 over root 2. Root 2 is just too hard to draw. And Alex, oh, pink like he is there, is going to tell me what this comes out to be.
All of it?
Huh?
Well, should that be negative 1, 0, 0, 3?
That's the only thing you have to do is you have to guess which of those is going to be, right? So he's not actually going to multiply it out. He's just going to guess which one it should be. And it turns out this is going to be, whoops, negative 1, 0, 0, 3. Whoops. Yeah.
Without multiplying it out, is there any way to know for sure which eigenvalue goes where? Or it's really just comes down to a guess?
Well, no. I mean, you just have to remember P is this guy.
Oh, it'll correspond to the order of the eigenvectors.
Yes.
Okay.
All right. This will similarly work out if you use the other order, and you get the other order of eigenvalues. Okay. And that's in the notes. I'm just not going to write it up. Okay, so that's symmetric. Now we can say, well, what about this statement? So we could go anti-symmetric. And do this all at once, orthogonal. Okay. For example, we can take B equals to minus B twiddle, and we can take B, B twiddle equals I. Like a 2x2 matrix, which has both of those properties. Adriana, just give me a 2x2 matrix which satisfies anti-symmetry and orthogonality. So in this case, we're using B equals 0, 1, minus 1, 0. Okay? It's going to satisfy anti-symmetry and orthogonality. It's going to satisfy both of these. That's why I'm picking it. Okay? All right. First thing we can do is we can shop for its eigenvalues. This is going to be lambda equals I and lambda 1 equals I, lambda 2. Equals minus I. Wow. My brain is no longer commanding my hand to write things, so I'll just be erasing a lot. Each of these has an associated eigenvector. The first one is going to be x1 hat equals 1 over root 2 I 1 over root 2. And the second one is going to be 1 over root 2 minus I 1 over root 2. Okay? Now, we once again have B diagonal equals P inverse BP, where P, and we're just going to pick one of them. P is 1 over root 2 minus 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2. Whoops, I root 2. I and I. Okay. Now in this situation, we have that P dagger P equals I. use this form, we're not gonna use the second form, so we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna say, all right, B diagonal equals P inverse, my God, maybe this is because I'm hunching down, I can't, I'm not that short. I'll just get it done on my knees. There we go. P inverse B P, where this is 1 over root 2, I 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2 minus I over 1 over root 2. And then this is going to be the matrix 0, 1, minus 1, 0. And then we're going to have P. P, 1 over root 2. 1 over root 2 minus I, 1 over root 2 of I, 1 over root 2. Okay. Is Caitlin here? Henry, what you gonna get? You can spell plot out.
Yeah, I could do that.
You could do that.
Or, I have to double check what order we use, but you're gonna have an I and a negative I and a diagonal in some order.
Okay. I'll give you a guess. It's 50-50.
Course grade depends on.
I think we have it set up so it's gonna be minus I.
Minus I, I. So minus I here. So I'll just draw an I and an I, and you're saying put the minus there?
Yes.
You're saying that?
I'm saying that.
Or you're kind of dreaming it, meaning it, but you're kind of really seriously putting the minus.
Now I'm starting to doubt everything.
Okay. I can't even draw a minus anymore. There we go. That's it.
I think it was a minus.
Okay.
Didn't you put the X2 vector first in the P matrix?
Oh shit, no, you're right. I'm gonna get this answer for the second one. Wow, you're really good. You students, just come on up here. You can take the notes, you can take the pen, you can take the cards. There's even a card at the end there, and you need to do this. Yeah, I was looking at the second answer, so you were right. You got me. I'll give you something. Give him the bird.
You like to pass this?
Yeah, pass it over to him. Give him the bird. Okay, all right. That's, I didn't say to have fun with it.
Yeah,
sorry. Yeah, it's a good sign. Okay, so are there any questions about this? Now it's going to get confusing. And now it's going to get confusing to me, which means it's going to get confusing to you. So we're done with this. I've written these two theorems, these two results out there, theorems there. But I wrote them out at the end of last lecture, and then I started this lecture with them as if you had never seen them before. That's kind of strange, but I wrote them differently. That was even stranger. I treated them last time as theorems that required proof, and I proved them to you. But then remember at the beginning of class today, I said we're not going to do any proofs. So then when I introduced them at the beginning of this class's notes, I wrote them again and just gave examples of them. So now I have like proof and an example. So, and the proofs are much shorter than the examples, is the funny thing. So I might just do both of them for you. But anyway, this is the only time I'm gonna lie because I'm gonna do a proof, but I want you to see how simple these proofs are. So we'll look at one. So one is if A is any linear combination, that's not linear combination, that's linear operator. I don't know why I wrote combination, but I did. Linear operator with eigenvalues lambda I, then a dagger has short. Proof. Recall. Recall. Lambda came from debt A minus lambda I equals zero, okay? But debt A equals, well, we can take the determinant of A dagger and star it, and then those are going to be the same. Therefore, debt A star is debt A transpose. Okay? So now, since debt A minus lambda I equals zero, and this is also equal to debt A, oh, I just don't want to do this. Put a bracket on that. Where this is A minus lambda I star, then we have debt A minus lambda I dagger is equal to zero, which is equal to the debt of A dagger minus lambda star I. It's horrible if you debt that debt. That's not much better. But if you think about it, hence A dagger and lambda star, or I should say lambda star R, lambda star are eigenvalues of A star. Now, that's proof. Let's see the example. Now, with examples, we can go ahead and add on one more useful fact, and that is, consider A with lambda and A star, or a dagger, with lambda star. Okay? The geometric multiplicity of lambda is the same as lambda star. Let's consider these in an example. So what we can say is, if we consider A equals I plus 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, I 1, 1, I, what are the values of lambda associated with this? Let me grab a card. Oh man, Evan.
DL.
What are the values of lambda?
Well, we'll have to.
So what values of lambda will make this zero?
Should we expand it out?
You can, but I think you can get it there. I mean, maybe you expand that out, but you can get that one automatically. If lambda is equal to this.
Oh yeah, we do get one of them. It would have to be I plus one.
Yeah, so we'll just call lambda one equals I plus one, okay? We just have to use the quadratic equation.
Yeah.
Let's just do it. Okay, so lambda 2 is going to be 2i plus 4 minus 8, or minus 4 plus 8, over 2. What's that going to come out to be? Now you have to do this.
That says 4 plus 8.
Minus 4 plus 8.
Minus 4 plus 8. Okay. So then we'll have I plus or minus.
No, plus or minus. It's just plus.
Just plus.
I.
1.
Yeah, because the 2 here cancels with the two pi on top. So this is going to be I plus 1. And I don't know why my markers aren't working. I plus 1. Okay? And then lambda 3, I'll just use you.
Well, they always come in complex conjugate pairs. So we can just say the next one would be.
What comes in complex conjugate pairs?
Don't the eigenvalues, they always?
Well, these aren't complex conjugates.
No, but the third one.
So the third one would basically be this with a minus.
Yeah. Oh, okay. So then it would just be I minus one.
Yeah, so it would be I minus one. Okay. You got that?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, well, let's shoot. Well, A dagger has eigenvalues lambda I star, so why don't we just do the same thing for A dagger and see if it has the eigenvalues lambda star. So in this case, A dagger is, oh boy. So remember, this is a transpose and a complex conjugation. So the transpose isn't changing anything. Everybody see that? But the complex conjugation is changing all the i's to minus i's and vice versa. Okay? So this is going to be minus I plus 1, 0, 0, minus I, 1, 1, minus I, 0, 0. Okay? We do the determinant of this, minus I plus 1, minus lambda, minus I, minus lambda, minus I, minus lambda, 1, 1. And we set that equal to 0. That expression is going to be basically minus 1 plus lambda. Oops. That's terrible. Minus I plus 1 minus lambda star. Lambda star squared. Plus 2i lambda star minus 2. Okay? I just went ahead and wrote this like this. Okay? This, after some thought, comes to the eigenvalue spectrum. Lambda star equals. Now you think I'm going to work this out? Or you think I'm just going to look at the answers and write down what this should be?
Just look at the answers.
Yeah. Because look, this proof, I mean, okay, you can work them out, but they're gonna be this, okay?
So I'll just write them down.
It's gonna be minus one plus, or minus I.
I can just put one.
Plus one. I'm just gonna shut up and write them down. Lambda two is minus I plus one. And lambda three is minus I minus one.
Okay.
The lambdas inside of the determinant of the matrix, those are also lambda star, correct? It's just like a notation thing.
No, they're not lambda star, they're just lambda. Because lambda is an unknown, so you wouldn't call it lambda star.
Oh, I don't know why, but maybe.
I don't know why I put lambda star there. That was weird. Okay. That was in the notes. That's what confused me. There was a star in there, but there should have been a star in there.
Okay. So this is as promised by this theorem, and also as promised by this theorem. Because each of the lambdas has the same geometric multiplicity. We have two on this one, we have one on that one. Okay? Yeah?
Wouldn't proving the first one just like automatically prove the second one? Wouldn't proving that first theorem automatically prove the second theorem?
If A is any linear operator with eigenvalues lambda I, then A star or A dagger has eigenvalues lambda I star.
Yeah?
Yeah. That's why I'm not providing you the proof. it was just a fact that was given in the book. Okay, so now we're gonna skip to, the second part of this, which is gonna get really confusing. And I have to decide what form to use because they use two different, or I use two different forms. this is hilarious. Let me try it this way. Okay. If any A has an eigenvalue. Vector xi and a dagger has an eigenvalue lambda j star and here's where I'm going to change it to try and make these two things synonymous. With an eigenvector yj, then the inner product of xi and yj is zero whenever lambda I does not agree with lambda j. Okay.
Lambda j or lambda j star? For the last, lambda I does not agree.
eigenvalues lambda I, then a dagger has eigenvalues lambda A or lambda I star. So down here, if A has eigenvalues lambda I and A dagger has lambda values lambda J star, and I take I equal to J, I can't be.
Yeah.
Okay. So then you have to take lambda I compared to lambda J. All right, but let's prove it. Okay. So proof. Consider A xi equals lambda I xi. Okay? Then we can say that the inner product of xj with xi, axi, sorry. Well, you know that we can evaluate axi as lambda I xi, and then we just pull that lambda out. So this is going to be lambda I xj xi. Okay? But if we define the adjoint A as A dagger xj xi, then this is going to be, well, it's going to be lambda j dagger xj xi. And what happens when I pull that lambda j dagger out? It what?
It's real.
Yeah, it's real because it's coming out of the first term in the.
Well, it's complex conjugate.
No.
Or it's real. Well, I meant real, but I just meant like you undo the complex conjugate.
Yes, when you undo the complex conjugate, that's what. Yeah, that's true. Okay, so this is going to be lambda j, xj, xi. Okay. Now we just take these. And we subtract them. Lambda I minus lambda j times the inner product of xj xi equals zero. These are not equal, this has to be zero. Put this into an example. Unfortunately, we already have this great example up here, so we'll just stuff it into this one. So we'll say, okay, let's get the A and the A dagger. Let's just find the eigenvectors of A. And these are going to be lambda 1, comma 2. In this case, we're going to plug in lambda I plus 1 because it's the same. Okay, that's why we're going to get two eigenvectors from it. So we're going to get I plus 1, I 1, 1, I, acting on some unknown vector A, B, C, and that's going to be equal to I A plus A. I, B, to IC plus C. Chris.
That looks so different.
I don't think so.
Yeah, you do.
So A can be anything and B has to equal C?
A, that's exactly right. A can be anything. This looks like a little D. First letter of A. There you go. A is anything and B is equal to C. So this is going to give me my two eigenvectors, I1, which is going to be 1, 0, 0. And then we can Gram-Schmidt it to get the second. And that will give us x2 hat is 0, 0, 1 over root 2. Now we can do with the third eigenvalue. This is going to give us I plus 1, I, 1, 1, I. Yeah. On A, B, C. And this time we're going to get IA minus A, IB minus B, IC minus C. And our conditions this time are going to be IA plus A equals IA minus A, IB plus C equals IB minus B, B plus IC is equal to IC minus C. Calvert, what's it going to be? What are the conditions?
A is 0 and then B is equal to negative C.
Okay. In this case, we're going to get the last eigenvector. 0, 1 over root 2, minus 1 over root 2. Okay? And then we can very quickly do the eigenvectors of A star. I'll just write this down. Eigenvectors star 1, 2 are going to play out to be exactly the same. So they're going to have lambda star. Yeah, we're just going to get this out of the arrow sign. Y 1 is 1, 0, 0. And Y 2 0, 1 half, 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2. And lambda 3 is going to give us 0, 1 over root 2, minus 1 over root 2. Okay.
They're the same eigenvectors?
I know, it looks the same, doesn't it? It's very strange.
But notice it's only the matrix and the eigenvalue that take these forms which connect them to the form over here. What we're doing is we're discovering what it is about the eigenvectors. And here we go. Let's look at this. Well, if I take x hat 1 and y3, This is associated with lambda 1. And this is associated with lambda 3. Okay. Is this equal? Lambda 1 and lambda 3? No. So what should that be? Should be 0, okay? So this is 0. And furthermore, we can go ahead and we can list a whole bunch of these. X 2, Y 3, which is associated with lambda 2 and lambda 3. Those are not equal either. See that? Okay, and so it should be 0 as well. And then if we take x3, y1, that's lambda 3, lambda 1, those are not equal either, so that should be 0. And finally, x3, y2. Which should be lambda 3, not being equal to lambda 2. Okay? So all of those work out for this example. So first, we're going to generalize this. So actually, we'll just go ahead and write up the generalization. The equation A minus lambda I x equals y has a solution. Once again, let's just look at a example. So we're going to take that over there, and we're going to take lambda 1, which is the I plus 1 eigenvalue. Then we're going to have I plus 1 minus I minus 1 I minus I minus 1, I minus I minus 1, 1, 1, okay? So this is A minus lambda I. So let it act on A, B, C. We will call x, might as well just call this y. Okay. So a minus lambda I x equals y. Okay. This is this guy. And now we say, okay, well, what if I'm determining a dagger minus lambda star I on phi I equals zero? So if I do that, then I'm going to get minus I plus one plus I minus one. Because remember, I'm basically daggering A, and I'm complex conjugating lambda. I'm getting minus I plus I minus 1, 1, 1, minus I plus I minus 1 times A, B, C. But this should be 0. Therefore, we can write phi should be A, B, B. This means we can have phi 1 equals 1, 0, 0. And then Gram-Schmidting, to get the second one, we'll get phi 2 is 0, 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2. Okay? You ready? If we let y equals 1, 0, 0. Okay. Then this tells us that, oh, wow, we got 1. Well, we'll go the other way. 0 is equal to 1. 1 doesn't look good. Minus b plus c is equal to 0. B minus c is equal to 0. There's no solution. Okay? So we got no solution. But notice the inner product of y with phi 1 does not equal 0. So we can instead try y equals 0, 1, 0, which is going to give me 0 equals 0. Looks good, right? Looks a lot better. Yeah. Good. Minus b plus c equals 1, and b minus c equals 0. This, of course, corresponds to y times phi 2, which is not 0. Is that a solution? Nope. Let's try one more. Maybe this will have a solution. Maybe we'll get lucky. So let's try y equals 0, 0, 1. Which is going to give me zero equals zero, that's awesome, minus b plus c equals zero, that's good, b minus c equals one. Okay, no solution. This is just y times phi 2. Okay. let's try y equals 0, 1, minus 1, which gives me 0 equals 0 minus b plus c equals 1, b minus c equals minus 1, and this is going to give me a solution. Oh, look, a, b, 1 plus b. So this is going to give me a solution. Why is it going to give me a solution? Y and 5, 2? It's because the inner product of y with phi 1 is 0, as is the inner product of y with phi 2. Questions, but yeah.
The third one that didn't like yield a solution, is that supposed to be like y inner product did with phi 3 or phi 2?
You're talking about this one?
Yes.
Phi 3. My 3 is working a lot, like my 2 is going to run. That's this phi 2.
Yeah. Okay.
This is a different phi 2. Anyone else? Okay. All right. So, now we're going to jump to something completely different. Use of these things in particular contexts. This is going to seem really weird, but just hang on. We're now going to look at it's going to be fun though. It's going to be a lot of fun. You're going to be like, wow, that's so fun. Chapter of the book that I felt like I had to cover, even though it was just like kind of boring. Okay, this is from Minimal Principles section. And we have the following. If A is self-adjoint, A X lambda x, if and only if I equals x a x is extremized, with respect to the constraint is this lambdas. Okay? So I'm going to work with an example of this. It's going to be kind of long, so just kind of, what does extremized mean?
Ooh. What is extremized?
You're going to find out. Okay. So, it's funny. I said recall, and I was like, God, where the hell? We've seen this in the notes before. But recall this matrix. So we had a big one. Three, and then one. You know, one, one, one. Two. And then we'll finish it off with zeros. Okay? First of all, A is equal to a dagger. Why is that important? Yes, the first statement of the theorem. So if it's not true, you're screwed. You're never going to prove. You're never going to demonstrate the theorem out of. You're not going to demonstrate this theorem out of a matrix, which is not a dagger A. Okay, well, let's go ahead and find out the eigenvalues. So these are lambda I equals, and I'm just going to run a set, and I'm going to call them lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 4, lambda 5. Again, vectors are x1 comes out to be a 0, 0, 0. Okay, so this of course says that a is anything, and so the first normalized eigenvector is just 1, 0, 0, 0. Okay, x2 is 0, b, b, b. This tells us that b is anything. So we can write down that this is x2 1 over root 3, 0, 1, 1, 1. Okay? X3, which we conclude is 0, A, B, C, such that A plus B plus C equals 0. Okay? Well, that's all it gives us. And x4 is 0, d, e, f, such that d plus e plus f equals 0. Okay? Now, what we want to do is we want to see this in the extremizing language. Okay, so let's stuff it into the extremizing language. So I going to be A, B, C, D.
this is subject to x inner product with x, which is going to be a squared plus b squared plus c squared plus d squared, is 1. Okay? Now, we're going to rather call the constraint j, and we're going to write a squared plus b squared plus c squared plus d squared minus 1 is 0. Okay? And then to extremize, consider k, which is the identity, minus lambda j. Okay? And this is going to be 3, no, it's not going to be the identity, sorry, it's going to be this. This is going to be 3 minus,
yeah, I don't know why they call it A. The exponential value of I is just, I don't know why they call it. Anybody have any idea why they would call it I?
I for inner product instead of I for identity, maybe.
Yeah.
Is it going to be comp the identity?
Say it again?
Is it going to be comp the identity? Or?
No. So, yeah, for some reason the book used an I there, and I think I is just, well, it's not an identity, right? So, it's not a matrix.
It's a number.
Yeah, it's a number. Okay, so I guess I as a number can be kept separate from I as a matrix. But anyway, we'll just stick with it. All right, so k is I minus lambda j, so let's write that down. Okay, 3 minus lambda times a squared plus 1 minus lambda times b squared plus 1 minus lambda times c squared plus 1 minus lambda, oh, this is so easy, d squared plus lambda plus 4bc plus 4bd plus 4cd. We want to extremize, but we've only considered that. Now we're going to put some extremization conditions on it. Therefore, we're going to say, now demand that partial k with respect to A is the same as partial k with respect to B, which is the same as partial k with respect, or sorry, B, with respect to C, is the same as partial k with respect to D, which is 0.
I see he's lying about an extreme now.
Okay, so now we can just take these partials, partial k, partial a, well, that's 6 minus 2 lambda a equals 0, partial k, partial b is 1 minus lambda 2b plus 4c plus 4d equals 0. Partial k, partial c is 1 minus lambda 2c plus 4b plus 4d equals 0. And finally, partial k, partial d equals 1 minus lambda 2d plus
4b plus 4c equals 0. Okay? So I got four equations. Lambda equals, well, lambda's not known. Lambda's what we're going to find from these equations. Okay? So what we can do is we can turn, so we'll turn the lambda dial. I heard laughing. I'm not telling a joke. This is a very serious class. Except this is very, I make no jokes in this class.
Where's the dial? I don't see any dial.
We'll worry about the rest of it. It's got to go from 3 to 5 to minus 1 at least. Okay. So, all right, if we turn it to lambda equals 3, then this is going to give us, let's see, oh, if lambda is equal to 3, yeah, it's going to give us 0 times a equals 0. It's going to give us minus 4b plus 4c plus 4d equals 0. It's going to give us minus 4c plus 4b plus 4d equals 0. And it's going to give us minus 4d plus 4b plus 4c equals 0. This tells us that a can be anything. These tell us that d equals b equals c.
This is a way easier way to find eigenvectors. This is a way easier way to find eigenvectors.
There's a way easier, or this is the way?
This is the way easier way to find eigenvectors.
Am I done? Yeah, they equal 0. Okay. All right. Well, that's one. We can take this and we can say, well, we found it, so we can just check, you know, what is x? X. Well, that just tells me a is equal to 1. Therefore, 1, 0, 0, 0 is my eigenvector. And lastly, if I plug it into I, well, that's going to be 3a squared. Okay.
Just do it right here.
A is the only thing that is not zero, so it turns out to be 1. All of this is 0, so this is just going to be 3. Okay? Well, let's keep turning the dial. Let's turn the dial up to 5. So if the dial is at 5, then we're going to have minus 4a equals 0. This is going to tell us that a is 0. And then we're going to have minus 8b plus 4c plus 4d equals 0. Minus 8c plus 4b plus 4d equals 0. And minus 8d plus 4b plus 4c equals 0. If I take all of these into account, I'm going to get that B equals C equals D with no long as they're the same, they can be anything.
Okay.
Well, fine, let's just check this. If x interproductive with x is 1, then this tells us that b equals c equals d equals 1 root 3. That is 0, 1 root 3, 1 root 3, 1 root 3. Okay? And we can figure out what I is going to be. I is going to be, now remember, I has got a lot of E, C's, and D's. Okay? It's got no A's. So if we just work this out, it's going to be 5 times A squared, B squared, plus C squared, plus D squared. That's what this is going to work out to be. So what's that going to be?
5.
Okay. And then I'll just finish it up with this, and we'll go home. If lambda is equal to minus 1, then this tells us 4a equals 0, 4b plus 4c plus 4d equals 0. This is just going to be the same equation, just jumbled. So this is telling me that B plus C plus D equals 0. And if I go ahead and say, well, X equals 1, then this is telling me that 0 root 2 minus root 2, whoa, 0, or 0, 1/3, and minus 2/3. And then I is B plus C plus D squared plus 2bc plus 2cb plus 2bd minus 1.
Same thing.
Alright? We good? Oh no. That will finish today. I am